Hey guys, welcome to our channel Cursor.run, where we usually do some tech talks. So in today's session, we are going to talk about Microsoft Dynamics 365 Finance and DevOps and how these two things are work together, how we work with build servers, dev servers, some branching strategies, some how do we create pipelines for continuous integration and continuous delivery. A brief background about myself. I'm Rahul. I have more than 16 years of experience in the IT industry. So this is what I do. Guys, if you are new to this channel, please do subscribe our YouTube channel and Twitter and Facebook handles. The same names are CursorRun, CursorRun. So let's get started. So today's agenda is we are going to talk about build servers. We are going to deploy and configure a new build server, dev machines, and we will connect these two with our DevOps, Azure DevOps project. And then we will talk about briefly around branching strategies, what people do and whatever suits you guys and what are the options we have. Then we'll talk about builds, release pipelines and CI/CD setup here. So before we can deploy a build server or a dev server, the requirement is you need to have a DevOps project, and that project needs to be linked with your lifecycle services project as well. We have already done this thing in our last session. What I will do, I will put a link in the description about the YouTube video and the blog post about which talks about linking and creating this prerequisite thing. The today's session will be concentrated on creating and deploying build and dev servers. So we'll see, this is the agenda for today, and we will try to cover all this stuff today. And then in the then later on we will talk about pipelines and branching strategy. Okay, so let's get started. Okay guys, if you refer back the our previous session, this is where we left. We created a DevOps project and we linked it back to our LCS project, and this is where we link it. You need to go to project settings, go to Visual Studio Team Services, pick your, let me show you your our DevOps as well. Hold on a second. Yeah, so this is our DevOps organization. We are working on Rahul Sharma organization, whatever organization you have, you can work on it. Then we created a new project. You can create a new project from here. The main thing is, let me try to click here. The main thing is just make sure the version control is set to Team Foundation version control. And this is the, that's it. So once the project is created, you can go back to your LCS project and finish the setup here. The detailed setup is, like I said, explained in the previous session. So today, let's go to the project. If you see, like, we don't have any machine whatsoever as of now. And our DevOps repository is blank, nothing here. Pipelines are blank, no pipelines whatsoever. So, yeah, so let's click on the environment, this plus sign. This will take you to new environment creation wizard, or you can go to your cloud hosted environments based on your license, whatever. If you want to deploy a managed server or the cloud hosted environments, are those environments which are hosted on your Azure, your company's Azure subscription. So let's create a new environment, select the version. So we are going to stick to new latest version, click next. Now you have two topologies. Demo is for creating a demo environment, which contains everything on one machine ready to go. But for today's for dev and build servers, we usually choose dev test. So then you can select the topology. If you are deploying a development environment, you can select the development, or if you are creating a build or test, so select the build. So today it's build. And name your environment. So I'm just going to call it ensure D365 Finance build box. And select the machine size. So I don't want to incur charges, so I will select the least expensive one. And let's go to advanced settings and see. So yeah, this is the main thing that you need to pay attention on. So pick a build agent name. I usually keep my build agent and build agent name as same as my build environment, so that I know which build agent is running what. Then you can you need to select agent pool. You can go with the default, or if you want, you can create a new pool. So if you want to create a new pool, go to your, let me show you again, go to your D365 project, go to project settings, agent pools, and this is the default one that LCS wizard was showing. So in our case, let's select and create a new one. Let's call this agent pool D365, so that this pool runs all our D365 projects and builds and all that stuff. Say create. So we have a D365 pool created. Go back to your LCS wizard where we were creating this. So pick, this is the name, right? D365. Yeah. So type in the name, agent pool name that you just created. Branch name is which branch you want to be configured. So if you leave it blank, it will just go to the main. Otherwise, you can pick whatever the branch you want to pick. And other than that, we don't want to, you can pick demo data, or you can leave it none, doesn't matter. But because in automatic test cases, you might be using your UAT or, you know, test database anyways. I'm just going to keep everything as is. I will change the virtual machine name, so that when I go to Azure portal, I know which machine belongs to which environment. And that's it. Done. Say we agree for everything. Next. Deploy. Deploying. So while this is deploying, it will take like somewhere around 4 to 5 hours. So I will just pause it here, and I'll see you just in a second. Okay, so it took more than 6 hours, seriously, to create a build server. So, but finally, if you see, the build server is deployed. And build server is deployed, so we are good here. And if you go to the build server details page, we see our virtual machine name is, our environment name is -bld, and our virtual machine name, actual server name is fbld-1, right? So this is all good, deployed here. If you want, at this point, if you want to log into environment, you can log into your environment. But let's go to Azure portal as well. So we are on Azure portal. So on Azure portal, if you go to the virtual machines, and if you see your virtual machines, you will see that newly created build server there. So build-1. If you go back to LCS, virtual machine name is bld-1, and it matches with our this server bld-1. So that's good. We are all set with the build server. But let's see before, because this video has stretched a lot. So I want to cut this video here, but before I cut end this session, let's see what it did on the DevOps side. So this is our DevOps project. So it did two things. Once the build server is deployed, it does two things. It creates your repository and it creates a pipeline. So if you go to your repository files, you will see it created a structure with a trunk. So it starts with the trunk. Under trunk, there is another folder called main. This will become our main branch. And in our next session, we'll see how to convert a folder into a branch. And the actual structure will look like this. So D365FO demands that you create your trunk and your branches in this structure. Though build server did it, but you could have like manually created these three or four folders. If you want to create more folders, just go click here, new and folder. So it will create a folder. So this is what it does on the repository side. And on the pipeline side, before I go further, so this is our main branch, going to be our main branch. Metadata folder contains all your source code, and project contains all your Visual Studio projects. Okay, and pipeline, it created a pipeline, built pipeline actually with this, with all the if you open it, with all the tasks and stages and whatever we require to build our application, to synchronize the application and create the artifacts and all that stuff. So we'll talk about all this in our next session. I want to end this session here because it took really long and it's like really late in the night. I'm tired right now. So let's go to the PowerPoint slide. So guys, today we started with this agenda, like creation of build server, then branching, and then we wanted to do pipeline setups. So we did this, we created the DevOps project, or in our last session we created it. I will leave the link in the video description, how to create a new DevOps project and how to link it with the lifecycle project. Today in this session we created a new build server, created a new agent pool, the server itself, the build server deployment itself created the main branch structure for us, and it created a build pipeline. Okay, in the next session I want to create a separate video on how to create a new dev server and how to deploy a dev server and how to create development branches, how to map your development environment with the DevOps, with the DevOps branches and all that stuff. I want to create a separate video on this thing because if I do everything in one stretch, it will take hours. So I think guys, that's it for this video. And again, before you go away, if you like the video, please subscribe to the channel and follow me on Twitter and Facebook. Until then, goodbye, take care. We'll talk later. Bye-bye.